Dada. This is your brother, Elder General Abu Amin Ra. My brothers and sisters, it appears that if we want to get the word across, Facebook is not the place to do it. One of our basic needs is unity before we can do anything. That's our primary problem to resolve at this particular time. But it appears that a certain mindset operate on and depend on Facebook. I'm talking about deaf, dumb, and blind people. Gangsters, especially those who prey on their own people, and other points that can be added. But for the sake of time, I would like to cut through the chase, as we say sometimes, and get to the gist of the matter. Here it is, right here. If unity is our primary concern and focus and goal before we can get liberation, have a land of our own, a sovereign land we can govern, protect, and defend, and extract its resources from to keep us alive and to do trade with others, then those are the kind of people that are on Facebook. It's a mixture of people. Some are Christians, some are Jews, Hebrew Israelites, some are Moors, some are Kemetans, some are Pan-Africans, and any and everything else. We can see that these are all barriers to bringing ourselves together as one force, one voice, one dream, one goal. You see, my brothers and sisters, I've noticed here, we help keep ourselves divided from one another. We have some of our brothers and sisters always condemning Christianity and the Christians. It is a very large section of black people that we seek to unite with us. Can't do it that way. Trust me. Because I could be wrong. But I know you're wrong if you think you can unite Christians when you're putting them down and when you're putting their religion down and the God they believe in down. It doesn't work that way. You isolate them. You make them your potential enemy. They're Muslims. So what? If some of us believe in Allah, the Prophet Muhammad, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, Malcolm X, Louis Farrakhan, so what? So what if some belong to the Hebrew Israelites and claim they are that which God sent into captivity for 400 years, and now the time is up, 1419. So what? These are petty differences that keep us divided. We are not fighting a religion in this war we are engaged in. We are struggling for liberation. Not liberation from religion, but liberation from racial oppression by those who originated in Europe and in the wilderness of Arabia. So united, we are the strongest force on the planet. But we assist in our captivity by constantly contributing to our division. Now let me tell you what we got to do, my brothers and sisters, like it, lump it, or leave it. I don't care. I'm giving you the truth. It is a result of my critically thinking about this situation. So it's not about religion. Religion shouldn't even be a part of the question. Be what you want to be, but don't criticize people's religion, because the purpose of all religions, I don't care what the name of it is to control the behavior of the people. Doesn't matter. But what we have to do, we have to teach our people what our struggle is all about, the options we have for obtaining these paths to get to where we're trying to go. We got to encourage our people. We got to do things. We got to love our people. Religion doesn't matter. We have to love one another as brothers and sisters. And stop putting other people's religion down. That's not your business. So the first step in unity is to stop putting people down, to stop castigating Christians, signing a God to the dump heap. It doesn't work that way. Stop talking about Yah, about his non-existence. It doesn't work that way. Don't put down Allah, because mostly Arabs worship him. It doesn't work that way. Too many black people are also Muslims. So my brothers and sisters, my advice to you, my demand of you, I demanded that each and every one of us stop putting down the various religions our people are in here in the United States of America and throughout the world. Because when you put a religion down, you're putting down sections of our people. When you put Christianity down, you're putting down a big percentage of black people. Nation of Islam next, followed by the Hebrew Israelites, and right on down the line. So my brothers and sisters, if we are going to come together and unite as a global force, or even as just a limited force within the United Snakes of America, we must first unite our power as one great power. You don't know who we are. We are God when we are united and focused on one goal and struggling to get there. So brothers and sisters, please, please, open your eye. They would have you, God, they would have. But open it. That place in your mind where light has the possibility of getting through. To an understanding that when we put Christians down, when we put the black Hebrew Israelites down, when we put the Muslims down, we are further dividing ourselves, and there's no way possible you can talk about our people's religion, because we are the true believers in whatever we believe, and expect them to come and fellowship with you and join hands with you in anything. So wise up, please. Stop criticizing the various religions and read some books and get some other subject to criticize us about. Unity, not further divisions. If you get what I'm saying, my brothers and sisters, if you get it, then please begin to act on it immediately. Love you. Once again, y'all. Peace.